Hi Leo, welcome to my channel. This is a love romantic relationship reading for you, Leo. This reading for today, Leo, is for the first week of Feb 2020, and this is a love romantic reading for the Leo friends, the Leo sign. Before I start, Leo, I want to thank you for your awesome support, your likes, and your subscribe. If you guys are interested to further support my channel, all the details that you need to know is down in the description box below. And yep, this is your reading. I have already shuffled the card, pre-picked the card for you, and this is your spread. So let us start your reading, Leo. All right, so this is your past energy, this is your overall energy. You've got here your current energy, the energy of your person, and this is the future immediate card advice. Okay, so in the past energy, Leo, you've got the Eight of Pentacles in reverse and the Three of Pentacles Eight of Pentacles in upright position and Three of Pentacles in reverse. It seems to be the past situation is that you are dealing with a person that is very workaholic, okay? Very workaholic, or a person who spends a lot of time at work or spends a lot of time in a specific hobby. I'm not sure whether this person has always been like this, or this could be a recent changes or pattern or cycle that somehow put a strain or issue or problem to your getting to know or to your relationship, okay? Because I feel like, you know, Three of Pentacles, they would rather work than to spend time with you, than to date you, than to be with you, than to talk to you. For some of you, for getting to know, you're dealing with a person who has who's very focused with a specific project, a goal, a career thing, a finances. This could be a CEO, something of a huge responsibility that they couldn't leave this Eight of Pentacles energy. So you're dealing with a person, a situation where you compete with the time. They don't have time because they have to devote themselves to career, travel, project. I don't know, maybe other responsibility. They could have other responsibility with family, or they could be, you know, they could have an ex, were divorced before, and they have to take care of kids because the wife is traveling, or the ex-wife or the ex-husband has to do something and they need to take over. But I feel like this is the blockages, this caused delay. You know, it has caused delay for this person not to have a lot of time with you. For some of you, for getting to know or dating, your dating situation, your dating, the level of dating that you have, it's downgraded because they've been busy. For some of you, there's been a change, you know, there's been a change with your dating situation, getting to know, reconnecting, because this person, they were caught up with something, Eight of Pentacles. For some of you, if this is not related to work or career, this is simply their attitude, you know. They're a person who is like, who enjoys all by myself kind of thing, you know. It is, because the Three of Pentacles in reverse, you know, they enjoy being alone. It could be the way they were, you know, bring up as a child. It could be a person who is a single child, you know. They're kind of in their world, you know. Eight of Pentacles, because if you look at the Eight of Pentacles, it's turning its back to the Three of Pentacles. It's more of, I want to be alone, I want to work hard, and I don't want to be bothered. Because the Three of Pentacles in reverse, this is when this is an upright position. If this is an upright position, this is working hard together with a group of people. This is the exact definition of this, is collaboration, working hard and collaboration with other people. Okay, team player, but it's in reverse. So this person, it could be you're fighting, you have an issue, you have some sort of drama, you have some sort of breakup, but this person, they want to be left alone, they want to work alone. Or it could be a person, a situation where they're a good person, they serve other people, family, they devote their time working hard, but they're not a good lover because they're turning their back to Three of Pentacles. So it's not a team player energy. Okay, this person is all by himself and is ignoring this team player effort. Because it would have been fun if he is working this much and he has inspiration, which is love and romantic, or he could have taken a break and then, you know, spend some time with you in a love romantic space. So yeah, it's kind of, it's a boring one for some of you, because Leo, you're very passionate and you find this person, for some of you, boring. But you find there's something good with this person, but they're kind of stuck in their own world, or the way this person operate is that I'm used to be like this, that we see each other once a week, I call you once a day, and that's it. That's pretty much it. You know, it's, this is my life. But he is not a good team player, you know, but they're a good person. They're very responsible, because look at them, all right? I feel like if this person committed with you, they would prioritize work over you guys. I'm not sure whether this energy, it's been always like that, or it's a temporary one, because I'm also picking up the pattern, the cycle has changed. Because it could be, you know, the way this person turned back to the Three of Pentacles is that it could be that this person, you upset them, or they upset you, or some sort of an issue that they don't want to hang around with you, that they don't want to spend time with you. They'd rather spend time with work, with other people, with a hobby, than to be with you or be personal with you, be spending time with love. They're not very romantic. That's what I'm getting. You know, I'm really getting, like, they're not very passionate or romantic, or some sort of, they have some sort of this interesting, they don't find it very inviting to be in a crowd. They're all about work, something like that. Yeah. So that's the past energy. That's the situation of your person. I also pick up some, you know, attitude and the situation possible in the past. All right. And you are Eight of Cups in reverse and Nine of Swords. So it seems to be you made a decision, because Nine of Swords, that, you know, you've come up to a point where you don't want to confuse yourself. You made a decision. You have one thought. You have one thing in mind. And that is to Eight of Cups in reverse. This is to go back. Or if you don't want to rekindle, to go back, to speak with this person, you're open to come back, to go back, or you're open to talk, okay? I feel like with your energy in here, Leo, is that it's more of you intuitively feel, or you know probably, that this would improve. This person is busy, moody for a certain period of time for some of you, and you know at some point that they would be able to come out of the Eight of Pentacles and eventually speak up or talk to you. Because for some of you, Leo, I'm picking up a specific time frame or a schedule where you expect this person to be so busy, to be so into this Eight of Pentacles energy. You know, for some of you, Leo, that you are in a time frame, in a situation where you have to take a break. Because I feel like your energy, Leo, is that it's a decision that I'm open to reconcile. I'm open to talk to you. I'm open to have, my life is still open for you, all right? If this is not the case, that you still want to rekindle, you still want to have an open conversation or connection with them, it could be that you haven't processed the emotions. Because, you know, Eight of Cups, when this is an upright position, this is you're leaving your feelings behind. But it's in reverse. It could be you break up, you separated, but you haven't really faced your own emotions, like repressed. Like you just move on, you're ignoring, but you're not facing the demon, you know, you're not facing your true feelings. Because I feel like eight of cups in reverse, this is, there's still a part of you that is wanting to go back to your person. Because I really feel like this person, he or she is not a bad person. He's just caught up with something that make him or her stuck with the Eight of Pentacles. that is separating you guys to be together, okay? I feel like this can be resolved. That's why for some Leo, you've got this Eight of Cups in reverse where part of you is saying, I need to heal, I need to take care of myself right now because the person I want is not available, all right? The person I want is overbooked. The person that I want romantically is not being romantic with me. He is being romantic to his, I don't know, finance, career, hobby, or other responsibility, but not about love. Okay, it is a competition, but it is not a third party. I don't sense a third party in here, okay? Because your person does not have time to even find, they don't have even time for themselves. So third party is not here. So if you break up, they're just stuck in this world of Eight of Pentacles. So they have the Eight of Pentacles and you've got the Eight of Cups. So for some of you, the way you deal with a breakup, a separation, or a no-talking scenario is that you have your thought that you have an open space left for them to come back, and them to ignore you, to forget you, is that to put all of their mind and heart to something that's keeping them busy, which is work. So you both have your own world or strategy to ignore each other, ignore the feelings, you know, because Eight of Cups for you, Leo, you're very much in touch with your emotions and passion with your person, okay, with your situation. It's like you just put your emotions and feelings into Pandora's box and you close it off, and someday, you know, for some of you, I'm feeling like soon you'll have to revisit that again and face your feelings. Because for some of you, you try to move on, but you know, there's this urge, hunch, intuitiveness that part of you is not ready, but you have to, like, part of you is not ready to give up already. You're not ready to move on. But what can you do if you're dealing with a person who is not really romantically inclined to be passionate or to develop feelings towards you, to develop romantic feelings because they're, don't know, stuck with work, stuck with something? Because this is, you know, leave me alone. I am not in the mood to collaborate or to be romantic. I honestly feel like this is temporary. I don't think that this would be like this forever, okay? So that is your energy, all right? In these two cards, there's also part of you who is half that, okay, given a chance, I'm gonna leave a space, an open door for you to come back when you are no longer, you're no longer, you know, a snub for some of you. But half of you is already in the moving on stage, because Eight of Cups is, I'm moving on, but I'm leaving a space here for you to someday you would have the thought to come back. You know, it really is half-half. I don't know. It could be, yeah, because this is sure, Nine of Swords. You have a sure decision-making that you want to go back, you want to revisit old feelings, or you haven't processed, you're moving on, healing, but you haven't really faced or answer those questions, or your person, they haven't given you some sort of a closure. That's why you are opening, because I'm really getting the word, I'm leaving the door open for you to explain and to give me some sort of closure, okay? But for some of you, you started healing, because the current energy is the Fool card. You started dating, you started to be happy again, although for some of you, you haven't really had some closure, okay? You are, I'd say, in control. You're in control of what you want and how you view the past and how you move forward. Because the Tower card is in reverse. This is kind of a feeling of you are accepting that current energy, you know, as of the moment, your person is still no talking, no response, or less response, still very cold, or not having a lot of time with you to develop that romantic feelings and or to level up this thing between the two of you into something exclusive. So you're kind of in that situation where your person, your situation, it hasn't changed. For some of you, there is a little bit of improvement, but that's not enough to really say that this is cool, this is great. It's still showing untouched, you know, it's still showing untouched, unfazed. It's still feeling like the past situation is still the same in the current energy or the present, okay? But what I love about your energy, Leo, you will have a full moon, Feb 9. That's why I feel like this week you're having some sort of pre-full moon energy where you're gonna take the risk. Like, you need to move. You know, the full card is saying here, I need to move. I probably like you, love you. You have a special place in my heart, but I need to move. So I need to enjoy my life, catch up with friends. I need to be open with other people. As much as I love you, I like you, I'm interested with you, but I have to move, all right? So that could be your energy, your intuition, your hunch this week. If not, then this is the advice of the card to you, because you're a powerful card, powerful sign. You are driven by passion. And the full card in here, it's not just being starting a new journey, but also removing the blockages. Because if you look at the full card, it is gonna, you know, it looks like the full card in here, it is looking like it's gonna walk past the tower in reverse. So you have some blockages, you have some delay, but it won't deter you to move. You know, to move. You cannot stay with this person. You can have your thoughts with them, leave it with them, or some sort of, I leave an open space, but I have to keep moving, because, you know, it's the full card. It is beginning a new journey while you carry with you some old stuff. You know, I feel like this rose, this is coming from your person. This is the memory, the peace that you find when you move. You know, so if you are at peace with your past, then starting a new journey is really an easy step. Okay, so what I pick up for you, Leo, is that, you know, current present energy is that you're encouraged to start a new journey, to move. Your overall energy is that you finally have a decision that, as much as I want you, I like you, I miss you, I love you, I cannot be stuck with this energy. I need to move. That's what I'm getting in here. Now let's look at the energy of your person. Your person, they are the Emperor. You could be dealing with an Aries, the Lover's card in reverse. Like what I've described to you, they're not really into romantic right now. The Emperor is a busy person. It's an Emperor. It runs an empire. I really feel like this Emperor, they haven't blinked. They couldn't blink. This is how much busy and how much they look after things in their life, okay? That they don't have time to have lovers, you know. Sorry, this was in the verse. So what I'm getting from your person's energy, you know, connecting this two cards in here, is that I'm sorry, you know, I cannot give you the commitment. I cannot commit to you wholeheartedly, so I better let you go, because I have some things in my life that I need to prioritize, okay? And yeah, for some of you, I'm getting the message that if I kept you, you might just be in the Nine of Swords energy in upright position. If they have kept you at bay, you would have the Nine of Swords in upright position, where you are stressed, you couldn't sleep at night, you couldn't get hold of them. You're trying to understand why a person can commit, or, you know, start a getting to know phase or stage with you, then they couldn't keep up, you know, because you're very passionate, you're very energetic. Like when you pour your heart into something, all passion is there. You know, so I would say these three cards, this intuitive message that I'm getting from your person, is that this is the best that I could do for you and me right now, is to focus with our individual goal. I feel like this Eight of Cups, you know, connecting the dots, the cards, and the intuitive message that someday I would be able to be, I will have time, and then maybe I could offer you that romantic love and that commitment, okay? Because I feel like, you know, they're the Emperor. They have to choose. Like, they cannot have, you know, it's more of, I'm not choosing a romantic partner right now. I'm choosing my empire. Because they're the Lover's card in reverse. So this could be a breakup, a separation, a legal. For some of you, they might be still processing legal stuff. That's why they cannot have the Lovers, because there's an ongoing battle legally. But what I feel with these three cards, Leo, is that if they offer a breakup, if they disconnected, if they lay low, it's because they have the Eight of Pentacles that's consuming their world. And it's the best. That's what I'm getting in here. It's best for you to have a space, or to have an individual life, you know. I think they have the same perception as you, that someday I would have time for this, but right now I feel like they're not into a team player romantic partner situation. They don't need that. It's a distraction for them, okay? In the immediate future, you've got the Chariot card in reverse and the Four of Cups. So I feel like in the near future, one of you will revisit, will text, will call, and you will kind of, sense check or test the water on how things are going with you or them, like individually. I really feel like in the near future, for some of you, it could be before February 8th or after February 8th or this month of February. I really feel like one of you will call each other, will check to each other and say, how's things? And I feel like when you communicate, when you connect or reconnect again, in that first conversation after, you know, after having a breakup or having some sort of, you know, a cool off moment, the conversation, it's sad. I feel a sense of sadness. Like part of you, you want to say, I miss you, I want to be with you, you know, I wish you, you know, I wish you the best, something like, for some of you it's a goodbye, but for 80% of you, you're really wanting to scream, to say that I wish you and I are together. But you sense in their voice and the way they talk that it is still the same scenario, okay? So it's quite sad that the immediate future, I feel like it is Feb month, that things, they haven't progressed or they haven't changed. Because Four of Cups, you call them or they call you and it's still the same. It is still the same energy. It hasn't progressed. They haven't improved their situation. Because the thing with your person is that if they have a free time, I mean, if they were able to, you know, sort out this Eight of Pentacles, then they would have a lot of time. They would have time to love or to have a love romantic, and that is you. And that's where you play. That's where you will be part of their world. Because I feel like in the nearest future, there's going to be a conversation again between the two of you. And you are holding back to say how much you miss them, you love them, or how much you like to be with them. You're holding that thought or that you know, that words, because in the conversation you still feel like they haven't changed. The situation is still an Eight of Pentacles. They're still moody, no time for love. You're dealing with a person, a situation where love is not their priority. If they have other people or if they go out, it's just to kill time and to take their mind out. I feel like this person that you're dealing with, they're so hard to themselves. Okay? So go on to your journey, Leo. Enjoy your life. And I really feel like the next cycle for the two of you is around April month. Okay, so good luck, and thank you for tuning in. I hope this resonated with you. I hope this gives you the message that will help you understand your situation. I hope there's an intuitive message that gives you clarity. This is one of the longest that I've done for Leo. It has taken me 25 minutes because there's a lot of energy in here. But one of the main points in here, Leo, is that keep moving. There would be blockages and delay. Leave them behind. Keep moving, okay? So you only have one full moon in 2020, and that's February 9. So this is where you become magnetic, attractive. So if this love situation does not work for you, then your charm, your magnetic personality will amplify this Feb, okay? You own February month, Leo, okay? This is the time you shine. A lot of people will be wanting your energy. So you have a lot of prospect, but you have to put out yourself there, okay? Good luck to you, Leo, and thank you so much for tuning in. I will see you soon again. Bye-bye.